So here we have the situation of going back to the moon. Just sit, stay put. The moon was, now, let me, did I explain about the photography? If you take a picture of somebody at twilight or at night, and you open it up the shutters a little bit, and you can get a photograph in about a half a second. And you can, through triangulation, you can tell you where that person is standing, whether they're standing in Australia, or they're standing in New Zealand, by the sky behind them. It is the gold standard, the gold standard of proving that you went where you claimed to go. Now, they have claimed that they went to the moon, 250,000 miles away. And they claim they went to Mars, or they sent little walkabouts to Mars. But they knock out the sky every time, so no one can prove that they are lying. They knocked out the skies. And by knockout, that means that you throw away the background. You just have a blank sky. Now, I've got a link here that I'll put here. What the real sky looks like. And this was taken by one of the NASA people on his own camera. And you can see that there's, once you get past this atmosphere, you can see double, maybe triple, the number of stars that they are just hanging in the sky, unblinking. Now, Alan Shepard, you know, he made a short hop. He was 23 days behind the cosmonaut Yuri Gagarin. I'm not sure it was genuine, because it was strategically and politically, it was supposedly to trump the Russians. But at any rate, Alan Shepard bragged about how gorgeous the sky was, that there was millions and millions of stars and they didn't blink. Well, later, when these moon astronauts came around, they were asked questions about what did they see outside the windows, and nobody had briefed them about what to say about stars. So they just said there weren't any stars. They didn't know what to say. It was really bad. But when the astronauts came back and were greeted as heroes of the nth degree, they, ticker tape parades, everything like that, their very first appearance was at a university. And I've never heard this story before last night. And I've got a link here so you can read it for yourself. That when the astronauts came to the university, they were pelted with eggs. The students threw eggs at them in fury for the big lie. I've never heard that story. They suppressed that completely. So these students, and I bet anything, they were astrophysics students and knew their stuff. You don't even have to be astrophysics. Just, you know, high school physics. And if you put your mind to it, you can figure out. There's no way those guys could have gone to the moon with that little bitty rocket. You'd need, with the amount of radiation, and it was known then, not as well as it is now, but it still was known, that it is in the outer space, the radiation is so high that you would need your rocket ship to have 7 feet of lead wrapped around it. How would you get it off of the runway? How would you get it off? Not only that, if you wanted to venture outside, your spacesuit had to be 7 feet thick of lead, or you would die. It is clear to me that no human will ever go out in outer space and come back alive. It's God's electric fence is out there. The radiation in the vacuum, a vacuum is when there's nothing in there. It's like a great suction. Anyway, it's very clear scientifically that no man has been to the moon. And all we have is a bunch of liars down here. And so we have all this propaganda going on. And that was 1969, okay? Ever since then, there has been an ongoing, by looking back, I'm saying, the beginning of the New World Order was starting back then. They wanted to command not all of space, just the first 250 miles of space. Do you understand what I'm saying? They control the Earth by flying over it, and they can always, at any time they want, once if they've developed it, blow up any country they want. Do you understand? That's what it was. So that's what this was all about. And Hubble was just a nice thing to make money. It didn't give us anything. And you wonder why we are all on Prozac? Well, anyway, as time went on, these people planned that they had to get us into the moon for invading countries that were not our own. And they knew which countries they wanted. It has nothing to do with democracy at all, and has everything to do with natural resources. And they have to come up. This is very painful for me. I've loved our military a great deal for many years, but I had never seen them be so badly misused as now, and the soldiers be so badly mistreated. The beginning of the New World Order was the developing an enemy that we could hate. Now this starts way back before Lockerbie crash, and we were being manipulated and trained to hate Muslims, you know, and because they were dark and they were scary, and you know, all this was manufactured. And then we had Entebbe, and those were supposedly Russians or Muslims, but they were actually Mossad. Anyway, there was just this big thing. Then they blew up the Marine barracks there in Lebanon, 250 Marines killed. So what did the administration do? They went and invaded Grenada, a little Club Med island, 3 days later. They didn't even have maps to it. So, you know, it's been a constant friction and increasing as it went on. And we have the towers, and we have preparation going on there. We have a man named Silverman by the towers 3 weeks earlier, and we have or 6 weeks earlier, and I'll go on from there. And I'm past time again.